this woman is claiming to be a Christian.
She specifically said in one of her TikToks,
This is a Christian album.
She called it a Christian album. Guys, real quick, I for some reason, I tend to say album when it's album. I don't know. What's up, guys? How you doing? I'm Paul.
I'm Morgan.
In today's video, we have an LGBTQ Christian artist who was able to grab the number one Christian album on iTunes, making some waves. I think it's worth talking about. So her name is Grace Baldridge, but her music name is similar. The title of this album, which was actually an EP that fell under the albums of iTunes, but it was called Preacher's Kid. Which, so, yeah, there's a lot here. Okay, this video goes a lot deeper, a lot broader, a lot vaster, more vast, than the relationship between LGBTQ and the Christian faith or the church. There's a lot that we're gonna hit on. There's a lot in her music. I just think this is a very relevant discussion for 2021 Christians and non-Christians. I mean, mostly Christians. What do you think?
Yeah. We'll say Christians because this woman is claiming to be a Christian. She's on the Christian album genre.
She specifically said in one of her TikToks,
This is a Christian album.
She called it a Christian album.
I submit it to streaming services as a Christian record because it is a Christian record. I'm just not the type of artist that industry likes to promote.
Does this shirt make me look like a homosexual?
I tend to say album. Christian album? I'm gonna go buy your album.
That's so annoying!
And it is annoying for Morgan, and I feel bad. Also, as you might be able to tell, there are palm trees behind us, and we are in short sleeve attire and sleeveless attire because we are in Florida taking a little 10-day workation, and we are honestly just beyond blessed and happy to be here.
So happy. But first, all right, before we get into any of that, that was a lot. Woo! Make sure you subscribe, turn on that notification bell if you want to be aware of when we're dropping new things or going live. We make videos on culture and social issues from a Christian perspective to help you have hope
and be free. Come on, bring freedom, Lord. Bring freedom and truth. Real quick, we love our patrons. We just want to give you guys a shout out. You guys are doing so much for this channel, and we are greatly appreciative. Thank you. If you want to become a patron and partner with us, click the link below or go to patreon.com/PaulandMorganShow. So quickly, we want to say, Grace, if you happen to watch this, we have love for you. We want to see you grow in your walk with the Lord. We want to see you walk in truth. The Bible says, speak the truth in love. So in this video, we're going to try to speak the truth, what we believe the Bible is saying, in love. We're not going to water it down, but our hearts are for you. Our hearts are for seeing people that maybe feel like they've been hurt by the church for whatever reason, wherever they're coming from, whatever sphere and walk of life, we want to see them grow in the Lord. But we are perhaps going to be speaking some challenging words in this video.
All right. Recently, a woman by the name of Grace Baldridge, aka Similar.
Similar.
That's her artist name. It's also her middle name. Dropped her EP called Preacher's Kid, and it soared the charts of the Christian genre on iTunes, Spotify, Apple Music. It reached number one, knocking out Lauren Daigle's Look Up Child album, which has been number one pretty steadily for the past 2 years. Knocking out Lauren Daigle's album, knocking out, you know, Bethel, Maverick City Music, all the Upper Room, whatever, all of the well-known Christian artists, gospel singers, is a pretty big deal.
Pretty big.
But we do just want to kind of explain a little bit of how analytics and stuff work when it comes to iTunes, Apple Music. One, Christian genre is not a very big genre. So if you drop an album and you can get a few hundred people to go pre-save your album is going to climb that chart really fast.
Yeah, so we're not trying to make this a bigger deal than it is. Yes, she was able to get a good amount of people downloading her album. I think she said she's had like 100,000 streams on Spotify. So she's had momentum as a LGBTQ artist in the Christian genre. And that's, you know, primarily the reason we're talking about this. Had momentum. It's not like she's had millions and millions of people. It's not like she's being played on all the Christian radio stations. I would venture to say she's at least been embraced by some people that claim to be Christians that are excited to see her message out there. A preacher's kid, grew up following the traditional rules.
My name is Grace, and I was raised in the church. Youth group, church camps, mission trips, the whole thing. My dad is literally a priest.
And now she's broke out, and you guys are gonna see when we start reading some of her song lyrics, it's pretty wild. It's out there. But on the other hand, there are other Christians that are looking at what she's doing, the content that she's putting out, the music she's creating, the stuff she's saying on her social media, and they are very concerned. And I think Morgan and I, and we're going to talk more about this, obviously, but we share those concerns as we see. And you guys are, you know, we're going to just peel the band-aid off and read some of these lyrics and let you guys decide for yourself, line it up with the word of God. But there is reason to be concerned.
It's interesting because she is very, like, firmly calling this a Christian album. And I think that's kind of where I, like, have the biggest issue with this. Not because she's LGBTQ, not because I don't think her songs are great or whatever. Like, it's because the lyrics, the songs in general, are not Christian songs. First of all, Christian music has, in my opinion, one purpose and one purpose only, which is to praise God for who he is and the creation that he's made. None of her songs do that. They're actually pretty blasphemous, in my opinion. I'm gonna just go there.
It's not just that they're not, you know, glorifying to God, but it's like almost she is out to spite, in my opinion, people that are Christians. Yeah. Is kind of what it feels like. Like she was on a mission, and perhaps, you know, in her effort to bring and welcome people that maybe have felt hurt by the church or feel like their ways of life, their lifestyles aren't accepted by the church, in her effort to do that, she's gone so far.
So one interesting thing about when you're uploading your album to iTunes, you have to select what genre of music you're putting on. To select Christian/gospel, you're not allowed to have any explicit language. You can't drop the F-bomb, you can't say GD, none of that stuff. Like, okay, that's not Christian music.
I didn't know that, but it makes sense.
Right. So she has a story where she, you know, selects, she's like uploading her album and she selects Christian gospel and it asks, does this have explicit language, blah blah blah, and she's like laughs and is like, well, guess we're gonna have to lie about this because this is a Christian album and we're gonna make sure that it says that it's a Christian album, so no, doesn't have. And she literally lies, straight up lies.
It, to her, in her mind, she's probably justifies that with, I'm a trailblazer, I'm done with the traditional way of Christianity, because in her songs she uses GD, uses of the F word. So again, in her mind, done with the traditional Christian values, we're bringing in a whole new way.
And I think that just also goes to show she is very much doing this with a purpose and a goal and a marketing strategy. Mm-hmm. Of, I am a gay woman writing a Christian album. This has never really been done before, or it's never made the chart, so like, let's make this happen.
I want to see a queer artist chart in Christian music. We have stories to tell and we deserve to be heard. And this is a big goal, so I'm going to need your help.
And that's a great marketing strategy. Well, if that's what you want to go off of in 2021.
She even said in a TikTok, come join me guys and let's have an amazing underdog story.
Producers have told me to my face, I'll never have a place in Christian music. Let's prove them wrong.
And one thing I heard Ruslan say in a video where he talked about this was that you have Christian, you know, Christian families, Christians that turn on their Christian music playlist on Pandora or wherever, feeling confident that what they're going to be listening to, the music that's going to, one after the other, is going to come through, is going to be wholesome. And suddenly, I don't know if this is gonna happen or not, but
probably would.
Suddenly Grace's song comes on and she's dropping the F-bombs. They don't even expect it because they think they're listening to a Christian music playlist or whatever.
This woman in like her late 30s is driving her minivan with her
kids,
four children, and what's this song?
GD, F-bombs. So it really is, it's like, that's just a disappointing taste. Just feels kind of low to me. Again, I get what she's doing, so to speak. I get that she's creating this movement. Everyone come along. We're about to do something that the Christian music has never seen. We're going to break open their box and bring in new stuff that needs to happen, the change that needs to happen in her mind, probably. You know, I see that side, but I do have deep concerns. Let's look at the lyrics of her song Bethlehem.
All right, so here's just a small snippet. She says, my dad's never cursed in his life. I asked if he smoked, he said twice. Well, by that standard, I'm a GD failure. I passed blunts the day I married my wife, but I'm a child of God, just in case you forgot. And you cast me out every single chance that you got.
It's obvious just right from there, she has church hurt. Morgan and I, many Christians, we go to the Word of God as our authority. That doesn't mean that some churches, some people are going to be perfect in that. We're sorting out how do you love people while still following the commands of God, the commands of Jesus. People are not perfect, so perhaps she had some church hurt. It sounds like she is out to push back.
I feel like the line of, you know, she says all these things, she smoked pot, she married a woman, she curses, whatever. And then, but I'm a child of God, just in case you forgot. I feel like this line is just like a, I can do whatever the heck I want and not, don't you dare call me out. Don't you hold me accountable. I'm still a child of God. I'll still be in heaven one day. Well, so you might have forgotten that. Well, let me just remind you.
So the obvious question is there any moral standard to live by?
Where is the Bible in any of her songs? That's my question. Where is the Bible in any of her songs? Well, I could not find it anywhere. And don't get me wrong, there's a ton of very rough, self-centered songs that I feel like are being played on K-Love and whatnot that I would say are not Christian songs necessarily either. But I feel like these songs as well, they're just, where is God in this?
Again, it's where does she get her moral authority? Does she have any moral authority? Because it doesn't appear to be the Bible. And if your moral authority is not the Bible, are you a Christian? Jesus says, if you love me, you will obey my commands. Let's keep going with the lyrics in Bethlehem.
Later on, she says, I'm saying, F a savior, and if she can't take it, then she's small. I'm going to ask a lot of questions because I'm giving this my all. You know the people preaching now, well, they've been putting us through.
S-H-I-T.
And if you don't sanction that, then why are you rewarding it? I'm assuming she's just talking about, like, people preaching now are putting the LGBTQ community through SHIT, and if you don't sanction it, then why are you rewarding it by, like, continuing to allow these people preach? I don't know. That's kind of what I'm assuming. Her song Chicken, it is all about a secret romance that she had, I'm assuming, in high school or middle school with another girl, how they were friends, but when they were together alone, they were more than friends, and so it's like this love affair song. So why is that on a Christian album? I'm not sure, but okay. In her song Youth Group, she says, you're not what they said about you, and a loser in a button-up can't send you to hell, no. At church camp youth group, they really tried it on us. Now we're grown up and we're effed up. Is there still a God we can trust?
Yeah, so, I mean, it seems there's a pattern in her songs going back to growing up in the church, and I guess this is maybe her way of exposing where she feels like the church messed up. I think there's a place for that. I think there's a place for calling out certain things within the church where the church needs to step up, making sure that the church is aligning itself with the teachings of the Bible and not taking stuff out of context and using it to be Pharisaical. Jesus called the Pharisees out, pretty much saying you guys are adding on to the Word of God and bringing in your own man-made traditions. So again, there's a place for that. It seems like she's just kind of on a mission to bash the church that she grew up in, bringing in this idea of out with the striving for holiness or perfection, in with the imperfect, we're owning exactly who we are.
And how we feel is okay. We don't ever have to push against those feelings. We don't ever have to question those feelings. If we're feeling them, then they're real and they need to be accepted and affirmed and loved.
I think you got to look at, okay, if you're exposing the church, perhaps that's okay. I mean, there's a place for that. What are you pushing people towards then? Are you pushing people out of a messed up church situation and to the truth and to God? Or are you pushing them toward what you were saying, live the way you feel? Just a faith that you kind of create, a man-created faith.
And I'll tell you who God is. I don't need the Bible to tell me who God is. I will tell you who God is. And when we start to do that and we start to live like that, God starts to look a lot like us, rather than looking like himself and us accepting him for exactly who he is, rather than trying to change him so that we don't have to change ourselves.
Churches are made up of imperfect people that are sometimes going to fail you. Doesn't mean you turn the other way and reject biblical Christianity. And that feels like what she's done. in my opinion.
All right, so we're going to share just a few comments that you guys sent us on our Instagram, whether we address them or just share them out with you guys to hear what other people are saying. Here they are.
Someone wrote, sinful? Question mark. Yes, but can this be an invitation of faith to those who have been hurt by the church?
So that's an interesting comment, and I would say not for this album, because that's not what it is, and we said this earlier. We feel like this entire album would push people away from wanting anything to do with God or religion or the church, so...
Yeah, that's kind of what I feel as well. What do you guys think? Someone wrote, I think her album has been released on the wrong charts. Are there elements of faith in her album? Yes. In her songs? Yes. But it's like, okay, does anyone who talks about religion or faith or lack thereof or anger at mean it should go in the Christian genre? I don't think so. Someone wrote, I think it's great. She's obviously talented and obviously loves Christ. The obviously talented, that's subjective. You guys can decide if you want to listen to her stuff. But obviously loves Christ is where I would push back. What makes you say that? I don't see, and you know, I'm not trying to speak for her. But again, the Bible says you will know them by their fruit. So what kind of fruit is she putting out? What is coming from the abundance of her heart? And I'm seeing not what I would consider good fruit that aligns with the scripture. Jesus talking about repentance and holiness. The Apostle Paul talking about holiness and putting away the desires of the flesh and taking on the new self. We died with Christ and we have been raised with him, leaving the sinful nature, putting on righteousness. And so I just don't really, I'm not really seeing that in the stuff that she's promoting, obviously without knowing her. And she could be the sweetest, kindest person. I'm just looking at the stuff that she is sharing with the world, and I have some deep concerns. Someone wrote, I hope you acknowledge you all aren't the ones to tell her she can't post that music. It's God's job to convict. She is sharing her heart and story with God, and that is her journey. It isn't our job to tell her she can't.
So, again, I'm not telling her that she can't write these songs or that she can't call herself a believer even. Like, she can do that if that's what she wants to do. But I think that it is fellow believers' place to say, hey, you're calling this a Christian album, let's discuss, because I totally disagree. This is not a Christian album.
The Apostle Paul specifically said, Christians aren't called to judge people outside the church, but is it not our job to judge those inside the church? Mm-hmm. He's saying, yes, we do have a responsibility. The Apostle Paul says, do not even eat with those claiming to be of the body of Christ, but are living in perpetual sin, knowing what they're doing and continuing to do it. So
take that for what it is.
It's pretty clear. You know, we're called not to judge hypocritically, but to make a right judgment. And people deserve to be called out when they are living in blatant, continuous sin. Someone wrote, I think it's amazing. This should open people's eyes to the toxicity of the church.
I don't really think that's what her album did, though. Again, I feel like it was just out of spite and like a place of like anger and frustration and hurt and past issues. And like maybe she would say now, and I'm sure she probably does say that she's totally like healed and recovered from her past stuff. But like, in my opinion, it didn't come across like that in her songs. And for me, one way of recovery and healing is to write songs. And so, you know, maybe that's what she was doing, and that's totally fine. But again, it was like she's in the middle of recovery, not I've fully recovered and here's how it happened. It's like I'm still recovering and here's my pain. Now hear me sing about how effed up the church is.
Like, yeah, well, I do not want to discredit her past and her experience. No. And perhaps she had one of the worst experiences going to church with a bunch of hypocrites that were saying one thing and doing another, mm-hmm. that were truly living like the devil and disguising it as faith in the church somehow.
And were genuinely hateful and gross to her.
I'm not gonna, I don't know, but I do know what the church is supposed to look like. And I do know what the Bible says. And so that's what I'm going to encourage the churches to be like. But again, that's not what she's doing. She's not pushing and encouraging the churches to the biblical standard. She's not. And so, I mean, that's just concerning on so many levels.
I do just want to acknowledge one musician to another musician. It is incredibly hard to write record, upload, and put out your art, your music that you've worked hours, days, months, years on. And so I give you credit, Grace, in doing that, and I just congratulate you in putting out work, because it's not an easy thing to do. So congrats. That said, we do not see eye to eye.
But man, we love you. And like I said earlier, we want to see you come into the fullness and love of Christ as we do all people that watch this. You guys know we love you all and we're for you all. Come on, Lord, help us. Help us, because we're all on a journey together. And this journey of faith, this journey of life has its challenges. Go to the Lord with them. Go to His Word and let Him help you. The Bible says, draw near to God and He will draw near to you. Come on. Let's do this together.
Comment below and let us know how you all felt in hearing this headline and topic, and how you felt about it being called a Christian album.
We invite you guys to share your comments. Let's keep the discussion going. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed Morgan and I stepping out and tackling this controversial topic. You guys have a wonderful rest of your day. We'll catch you again very soon. Have hope.
And be free.
Album. I'm going to go buy your album. Album. Christian album.